No. Okay, it comes under the alternative media now. It comes under the alternative media. If you go to the pages of physical newspapers or even online, you will see that there are so many people who write specialized columns. Some write on food, some write on politics, some write on economics, some write on education. So if you know an area that you are good in, you can decide to create a blog. Some write blogs on traveling. People want information. There's a guy they call on Waka Waka Doctor. So, is it Waka Waka? Yes, Waka Waka Doctor. Waka Waka Doctor is on Instagram. And what does he do? He uses the Instagram to educate us on places, countries that we can go to without spending so much. But we know what about Canada, whatever, US, UK, and all that. But what it does, like, it does so much, so many, she does a lot of statistics. And then blogs, and either we have blogs on traveling, or travels, and tourism. So, blogs are also part of the media, but like I said, they come in under the online or mainstream and alternative media. So you can, as a graduate of mass communication, you can say, okay, let me blog, let me start my own blog, and let me create my niche on this particular area. I know somebody who blogs, I mean, who focuses on, just on, she's a doctor, a pediatrician, yeah, just children doctor, and then decided to say, let me be known as somebody who writes or blogs on things that have to do with children's health. So there is a part of it, that's the direction you want to go. And then we're talking about how do they learn those skills. I mentioned in the course of my degree that they can go online to YouTube. The internet is an ocean of information and ocean of knowledge. But you must be able to know how to navigate it. So, but if you go to YouTube, once you know what you are looking for, but you must know the keyword, search engine, you must know the keyword to bring out what you are looking for. So the internet is a world, an ocean of so many information that you can actually use. They call it the University of the University of the World, the University of Knowledge, I can't remember. Then YouTube also, there's nothing you want to learn that you don't go to YouTube, you know that. There's no skill. The way they handle this camera, you learn how to do it. So many things. The way you can be a good broadcaster, you can be a good writer, you can learn it on even this enterprise you're talking about, you can see it. But the truth is there is also true. Despite the fact that you have, you go on YouTube, it's also true to network with people, learn with people that know it and probably subscribe to their courses or subscribe to their mentorship or their coaches. And then there are so many digital courses that you can learn that can help you. So please take advantage. There are so many courses, there are so many platforms like Coursera, Teachable, which was Seller is our Nigerian one. So many platforms you can go to learn. Even teachers these days, they leverage the internet. There's a guy I know, you're doing very well already, won the national award. I think it was the school of Bali that gave the national award. He created a platform where he can connect teachers to students. I know of a lady, she teaches to foreign students, and she makes, she's being paid in dollar. I know of a teacher, a young man who's a teacher, who teaches mathematics to students in US and UK, and then she gets paid in dollars. So you must know how to use the internet space for your own advantage. So many opportunities there. Which one is the other one? Says choice? You have to overcome stage fright. We are talking about public speaking, and then probably as a presenter on radio. And the radio can see, I guess, nobody seeing you, except these days where they do streaming. And then public speaking, as a resource person, just like I'm doing, how to overcome stage fright. Now, there are so many things you can do to overcome stage fright. One of them is, one, you must be familiar with the topic that you are now. What is the confidence to come and stand before you? Because I have experienced it and still experiencing it. I have done so, I've lectured before. I know the topics very well. I know I'm going to speak to students, so I'm familiar with students. So coming here to stand before you, there was no fright per se. So when you go on YouTube, you can learn so many things about how to overcome stage fright. And then there's what we call icebreaker. Icebreaker, I teach that in presentation classes too. When you come, look at your audience. You cannot speak on someone. Like when I came, like, what was the icebreaker? light. Tell your neighbor that you must not sleep, that they sleep, that they want, they will pay a fine. That was my headache. I was using it to calm down myself, to calm the tension, get your attention, get you engaged. So those are the little things that you can do towards to overcome, you know, stage fright. You know the topic that you're going to speak on? Icebreakers so that you can get the attention of women and so that you can calm yourself down.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for three questions. This one says, where is the best place to start on media entrepreneurship? Where is the best to start on media entrepreneurship? The second question says, how do I find my niche and stay consistent? Let me take those two.
Now, where do you start? Okay, where is the where? I don't understand what you mean. Is that you start in school or you start when you graduate? Okay. Okay, what's the first step? Okay. Now, you follow the slides. I told you, I said the first thing is to identify the problem you want to solve. If you don't have a problem you want to solve, if there's no gap you want to fill, how do you now come into entrepreneurship space? Because entrepreneurship is all about solving problems. So what you should begin to do right now as you're in school is to begin to research, begin to ask questions, begin to become inquisitive. Now what and what is happening in the media industry, including media is what you want to go to. If media is not what you want to go to, fine. You can find some other things, but there's a connection between the media and those other things. So you must look for what you want to do. For example, maybe somebody is doing cake in your neighborhood, and you know that this person is doing cake. This person's cake is so delicious that nobody person able to speak. And if they're a media person and if they're curious, you want to help this person to work to amplify what she's doing. You want to help this person to advertise, to tell people that is a solution. You want to be the person. I can help you make a noise about this thing. I can help you to create a jingle. I know that there's a young lady on Instagram who creates jingle for people on her own. She got those equipment, you know, this equipment, go to junior, go to go there, they sell some these little microphones, you know, your phone with your phone. So the mobile phone has become a tool. It's not just for saving our time and whatever, it has become a tool that people are using. You can decide to be a content creator for that cake maker, and then your journey into entrepreneurship comes. If your knowledge of mass communication also comes in, tell the person, I'm going to be your content creator. I'll be videoing you before and after. I'll be doing the jingle for you. Like I said, the person does jingle. What does the person do? He will, for example, when he's doing birthday, will just go to his page and then begin to present, say, oh, this person does cake, or this person doing birthday, instead I wish to this and not. And before you know it, she started gaining traction. Before you know it, started putting a price to the jingle that she helps people to do. There's a radio station, Jordan FM. It's an online radio station and they are doing very well. It was just an idea of somebody, Jordan FM. Go and go to join that organization that is giving traction. And what they do to all of these things I've mentioned, leveraging the tech, leveraging online to create a radio, branding it, putting a face to it, and then people began to listen. People began to listen to Dr. Alabi for music, am I right? But today, Dr. Alabi has a radio station on Instagram, online, very. They now have their own app. So there's so much you can do within the online space. She doesn't have a background in mass communication, but she presents a show and a program, and then she has sense. So if you don't have an idea, then we don't need to do it for them. But it's time that we need to do our thing ourselves. How about you, make sense?
Thank you so much, sir. The next question is, what is the name of your company? Does it allow internship training? You mentioned that the news media is mainstream and social media is alternative. But nowadays, most people would prefer social media over news media. We didn't say social media is mainstream.
I think the lecturer has come and asked us some of whether social media exists or not, or exists or yes, the mainstream will always be the most credible. The mainstream will always be the most credible because the social media platform space has been proliferated with so many people. They call it citizen journalism. I remember what I said about that. Citizen journalism, yes. Where something is happening somewhere and then you click to the video and then you throw it there. An accident happens somewhere, you quickly throw it, and then a credible journalist, a trained journalist sees it, and then he goes there to investigate. He one, as a trained journalist, as a professional, I know that the mainstream is still the most prevalent. So I know I go back there to verify whether they are there. Are we following? So social media is still there, but the mainstream is still mainstream. You are being trained, you know, to leverage the mainstream, and then you're also trained on how you can professionally handle social media. So as trained media people, we don't take everything like a center on social media. You get that? Okay, so those are at our agency. So it's called Smart Brand Media and Data Services. But for short, we are known as Smart Brand Media. It's also a media relations agency or PR agency as one to, you know, like and as one to call it. We have so many people who cannot afford to pay millions to a big PR or media relations agency. So they come to us, okay, can you just help us? We want to get this press release out. Want to get this, want to host a conference and help us arrange TV to do it. And so we help them, you know, to get them, you know, sorted out. Now we're taking that to take interns. For now, we don't take interns, but we can give the opportunity to learn. We have one or two or three persons in Columbia University. The final year student, they help us to write stories. They help us to write stories. So we have source stories to them. And get to pay them. So we can also give a standard opportunity to students of Taylor University. Because the drugs are just coming. The drugs are just coming and eat everything, so we need our source there. So we are good as a feature writer, we are good as can write press releases, and level and junior level and formula level. Because we don't want virtual. So we might not be able to never sit down to now for training or whatever. But we know that very soon we'll do something with, but as many of you that know, you're very good. We press releases, we can write copies very well, we can write features very well, we can always engage you. And then we also engage people that can help us do cover assignments. There are nice people organizations say, come and help us bring channels and bring our lives to this place. And because we are short, we have short of manpower, we can just call or people we have a relationship with, please go and help us with that. So we do that. So if you want more information, I'll see or discuss with the head of the department.
Thank you, sir. Next question is, my name is Tunde, and I own a company. I started, okay, it's called, I think, Shaba Media. I don't know. I take pictures of events and portraits. That's the main part of this part. Portraits. And it says, my question is, as a student, how do I balance pricing and get sponsorship to promote my business? I think that's the main part of this question. So he owns a media, he has a company, he takes pictures of events and portraits. So how can he, as a student, balance his pricing and then get sponsorship to promote his business?
Thank you. So it's a good one. It's a good step in the right direction that we started. Yeah. Has so many, you know, there's a bonding of the mass media. So I know that, and I was like, they took me to the photo, where they took photography. So some decided to say, okay, I want to just have my niche as probably an event photographer, a celebrity photographer, a makeup photographer, what do you call it now? For these things that they use, what do you call it now? I forgot to say. When it comes to items, when you take pictures of items, your product, there are people who are specialized in that. Okay. So then you can do, when you make sure that you are take portraits and all that, the truth is that there's no, you can completely, I don't know your time and I don't know your timetable. You are the one that will determine how you want to balance the two. You are the one that knows how you want to balance the two. Understand? But if you are resident here in Postel, and you have the opportunity of going out, fine, you can go out, you know, and do. So, but you are the one that will determine how you want to balance your time. However, you see that it's not really time. There are other things you can actually do within the same photographic space, because there are so many opportunities in it. So, one aspect of it is not giving you time. So, social media allows you to now do so many photo shoots. People are focused on photo shoots. People are focused on product shoots. For example, in Jumia, in Oka, there are photographers who take all the pictures that they upload online. Remember, most of them, their pictures are not videos, they are just pictures. So we have people who are professional in one photo, I mean, a product shoot. So you can decide that, okay, I'm going to be reaching out to those who have businesses and have products, and I'll become their photographer. So you create a niche along that line. Then, that's the price in which there are courses you can take to be able to know what price. Because so many things on prices come into play. A price for what you do. Environment is part of it. What you charge in a place like a Lemon shop cannot be the same price that you charge people in Lekki or in Magodo. So your environment also depends, and your clients too. The clients that you are dealing with also determines the price you will charge. The price you charge is celebrity. The price you charge a rich man is not the same. But what you have come to realize, that the time we're focusing just on SME, small, and even before the ones that gave us the leverage to start. When we started, we saw that it was difficult for us to break into corporate, you know, against corporate, new corporate organization. So we started with small business organization where we were charging them 10,000, 15,000, you know, and all that. But we decided that that could not pay our bill. So, but we used it to start, and then we began to scale. One person who helped us to scale, I must admit, the person online, you know, he's a very strong influencer. He had moved from Nigeria to abroad. We did something for him, free of charge. And then he mentioned us on his page. And that was how we moved from the private charging for to retire. And then our client, the kind of people, we said to ourselves that if we can allow this person and give us the opportunity to do a media, to do a PR for him, that means that we have what it takes to do for people in his caliber or in his startup. And that's how we scaled up from focusing on SMEs to people that are influencers, and then our price also will change. So you must put all of those factors into consideration. Otherwise, you don't show me. I know students cannot pay you for two photoshoots for students. They speak to you, or no, they can pay you. But if you change your clientele, then you know that you now have to mark up and do something better. There's what we call luxury clients. Yeah. to generate income. Yes, if you go online, there are platforms who are looking for freelancers, who are looking for people that can write for them. So many of them don't go to one platform, but you have to know the problem you want to solve. So it's not just because of the platform. What is your strength? What can you do? You are looking for a platform that is looking for people that can supply maybe pictures of the environment, pictures of animals. You are looking for somebody we have freelance. We have students who are freelancers, freelancing for a lot of media organizations that we see around. We see students who supply pictures, maybe of an accident, of an event, and they pay them. So there's no much opportunity for you. There's no platform. You want to go online and don't go to find people who are looking for people who can write content for them, people who can manage their social media. It's something the student can do. There are people who don't have time. All they want you to do is just make sure you manage their work, their pages, their social media pages. I know people, there's what we call, there's this lady, I forgot her name. There are people who manage it again. You know the Instagram, so the WhatsApp DM. People are looking for students who can manage their DM, that is virtual customer service. And there are people who train you on being a virtual customer assistant. I know of a lady who trains people and helps to get job abroad. So I think the virtual assistant, you go on Instagram, type the virtual assistant, the virtual T as in letter T, the virtual assistant. So she will teach you how you can get jobs from US, UK, from Canada, and you are in Nigeria here as a student. You are helping to manage clients, you are helping to manage customers. So those are platforms where a student of mass communication can generate funds as a student. So many opportunities. There are people who are looking for those that can pay skills. If you have your phone, you can learn how to do mobile cinematography. You can become a mobile cinematographer. What do? You go to them, you have your clients who engage you week in, week out. What do? You go there with your phone. You are there with your tripod or whatever, and then you video them and you go and you also learn video editing skills. You have InShot and all these other ones and so many of us know. So you learn how to use your phone to work, to edit, to take pictures, to do video and edit in a professional way. People are even doing courses on it. You go to Facebook, you see people charging 1,000 or 2,000, they'll teach you how to become a global cinematographer, how to edit pictures, 10 minutes pictures, 20 minutes editing, you know, and all the videos, and then people pay you, but people are looking for those that can help them do so many things on social media. So if you are paying photography, you are paying photography in class currently, you can create a flyer for yourself that you can help people to edit their videos, you can help people to shoot videos. There are people who use their own phone personally to shoot, but they don't have to edit, so they are a creative editor. You can navigate the phone, they can make money using your phone. Having edited in class, not use your phone, because you don't have resources to buy a big camera like this. So use your phone to edit videos, to edit pictures, and people pay you for that. They are doing graphics too. There are people who create graphic agencies. So as a student, you are doing graphics, you can become a, I have a son, my customer is last Tony Messi, but he's a graphic person. So he does some of my talent alongside Mumiro, but he doesn't have some other ones in school. So, and he's a student. So making money, helping churches to do graphics, helping little small businesses to do graphics, and they pay as much as whatever the time to take, that depends on what you are. Wow, that one's the idea comes from you being able to expose yourself. You have come here today to listen. So you listen, people do Instagram live on how to succeed in life, sharing success tips. So those are where ideas actually come from. And then you know how to reinvent the wheel. Ideas that I get an idea from an already existing idea. I don't know where I get it, so that's how idea comes. You know, ideas that already exist, you can create a mobile videography that you claim one. Okay, I can't afford to do videography like this. All of the features that I need is in my phone. Oh, an idea don't come. Okay, let me start my own videography. Let me go to YouTube and learn how to become a videographer, a cinematographer.
second one, I need your answer. In the process of media entrepreneurship, what's your thoughts, or what are your thoughts on the future of the media industry? As an entrepreneur, what are your thoughts on the future of the media industry? And the second person said, financial release, if we don't get sponsors, how do we support ourselves financially?
Yes, I'm actually a